In this video, I'm going to show the T200 tank robot chassis and how it can be used with the Raspberry Pi and a wireless USB controller. This is one of several different robots I've created. You can see more about the other robots on my robotics playlist on the Penguin Tutor YouTube channel. The T200 is a tank-style robot chassis with caterpillar tracks. It has an aluminium base and includes powerful 12-volt motors. It is one of my more expensive robot chassis, but it's quite powerful. The chassis comes as the base and motors, but everything else is added separately, including the Raspberry Pi, motor controller, batteries, and in my case, I 3D printed additional brackets, although those are not required if you don't have access to a 3D printer. Here, I've added a 12-volt remote control battery pack to the underside of the robot. In this case, I've added my own 3D printed bracket. More about that later. If you don't have a 3D printer, then you could use cable ties to hold the battery on instead. The battery comes with a Tamiya connector, and I wired up a corresponding connector to connect that to the circuitry. You can buy those pre-wired if you prefer. You'll also need a separate battery charger, as I haven't included that in the design. Whilst looking underneath, you can see the motors, which need wires to be soldered to them. The same if you want to use the LEDs at the front of the chassis. Back to the top view, you can see there are lots of different mounting holes for mounting components. Unfortunately, they don't quite line up with how I wanted, although I could have probably managed by drilling some additional holes or placing some of the components in different positions. Instead, I designed a top layer, which I mounted above the top of the chassis. This gave the exact holes I wanted, but also provided a way to hide many of the wires underneath. In this image, the front of the robot is at the bottom of the view, with the Raspberry Pi located at the top left. There are essentially three components needed on the robot, plus the wireless controller. The first is a Raspberry Pi. For a robot, I normally use a Raspberry Pi Zero, as it uses less power, but because this has a high power 12-volt supply, I used a full-size Raspberry Pi Model B instead. I didn't use a Raspberry Pi 4 though, as that uses a lot of power. Instead, I'm using a Raspberry Pi 2. The Raspberry Pi 2 doesn't include wireless networking, so there's a Wi-Fi dongle in one of the USB slots. The other USB dongle is for the USB wireless controller, which I'll explain later. This is a small DC to DC buck converter. It converts the 12-volt power to 5-volt required for the Raspberry Pi. They're fairly inexpensive and much more efficient than using a linear voltage regulator. Always test the voltage coming out of the regulator before connecting it up to your Raspberry Pi, as I found out the hard way. I had a faulty one, which put the full 12 volts out of the USB output, which was not good. Finally, there's the motor controller circuit board. This is a dual H-bridge based around the L29A10 motor controller IC. This is available as a complete circuit board, complete with the screw terminals for connecting to the motor and headers for connecting to the Raspberry Pi. You can use any GPIO pins from the Raspberry Pi to the motor. The source code is shared with the STS Pi robot, so it uses GPIO pins 19 and 20 for the left motor and 21 and 26 for the right motor. But you can use any other pins by changing the source code. The motor controller board includes its own built-in voltage regulator used by the L29A10 H-bridge IC, which is enabled using a jumper on the board. There is no need to connect ground to the GPIO on the Raspberry Pi, as if you're using the same power supply source, then the ground of the Raspberry Pi is already connected to the same supply, although there should not be any harm in adding an extra ground connection if you wish. Now, to finish up on the hardware, I'm going to show how the 3D printed Raspberry Pi board and the battery mount are made. These are created in FreeCAD, a free open source CAD tool. I've created a video suitable for beginners wanting to learn FreeCAD. This is the top plate. As you can see, it's mainly a flat plate with holes created for the various components. Starting with the top left, this is where the Raspberry Pi is mounted. There are additional circle holes which allows for the airflow to improve cooling, as well as to reduce the amount of PLA used when printing. The four mounting holes line up with the holes on the Raspberry Pi, which is mounted using PCB standoffs. The rectangular hole to the right can be used if you wish to pass through the camera connector. Note that the connector nearest the hole is the display connector, not the camera connector, but it allows the camera connector to take a straight line before changing direction under the board. It can also be useful when trying to feed wires from the GPIO connector for either the LEDs or additional add-ons if you want to add a distance sensor or some other automation. These four holes towards the bottom left line up with the motor controller board. The large circular hole can help with cooling and reduces the amount of PLA needed. To the right is a raised area to sit the buck converter in. It doesn't include any way to secure the converter as there are no mounting holes on the version I used, but it does make it easier to connect to a USB connector. The wire from the USB connector then goes through the square hole next to this. The other two large circular holes can be used for passing cables through, such as towards the motor. Finally, there are four holes for mounting the board to the chassis using the PCB mounts. Next, you can see the mounting bracket for the battery. This is based on a single module containing 10 AA batteries in a flat 2x5 configuration. The circular holes reduce the amount of PLA needed, but can also be helpful if you want to read any codes written on the battery. The mounting holes are countersunk for hex nuts to make installation easier. It is recommended that the battery holder is installed prior to the top plate. This image shows the battery holder the correct way around when mounted, although it was printed the other way around, so that the untidy area where the scaffold is printed is not visible. All the STL files for 3D printing are available on Thingiverse. See the link in the description. Or you can download all the files, including the original FreeCAD files, from my website www.penguintutor.com/robot. The source code is also available to download from www.penguintutor.com/robot. In this case, it uses a GPIO Zero robot object. It's designed to be controlled using a keyboard based around the numeric keypad. This uses pulse width modulation, PWM, to control the speed of the motors. I've already explained this in an earlier video. In that case, it was based around a model railway, but that's just a different DC motor. Essentially the same principles as the motors used in the robot. See the description for a link to that video if you want to understand how that works. By using the keypad for controlling the robot, you can also use a USB wireless controller with the help of Q Joypad. I've already covered this in an early video. Again, see the description or my website for a link to that, if that's something you'd like to use. Finally, here's some video of the robot driving around. If you haven't already, please consider subscribing to my channel for more robots, Raspberry Pi and other maker projects. In my next video on robotics, I'll be showing a different kind of robot, which is based around a custom chassis. It uses mechanism wheels, which provides additional movement direction, which I find quite interesting, so you might want to check that out. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up or share, and please leave me any comments if there's anything you'd like to see in future videos.